Hello, my name's Cody and I'm with LaunchDarkly. In the previous video, we showed very quickly bootstrapping a React-based application and integrating the React LaunchDarkly SDK into that application. We created our first feature flag in the LaunchDarkly platform and used it to control what logo displayed in the actual React application. In this video, we're going to expand that story and bring in a couple of new flag values to change that React application more. We'll bring in a string flag that'll let us push some dynamic content down to the page and use another flag value to control which component loads. Let's jump into it. So we've got that logo completed. Our application's changed a little bit, but I mentioned earlier that we wanted to drastically change this application. So we still have some older React-based stuff here that we want to clean out. So we'll go ahead and create another flag in here that'll be bottom text. Now I'm going to pop back into LaunchDarkly and I'm going to create this flag. We're going to feature flags, create a flag, bottom text. But instead of a Boolean flag, we're going to create a string flag this time. This string flag is going to contain effectively a snippet of text that we use to replace the bottom. This gives us a little bit more agility for when we maybe want to make an update to this page down the road, to where we can come into LaunchDarkly, make that change here, and have it update down to our application across any amount of SDKs that are using this SDK key. So we'll go deploy applications faster. And just for grins, we'll say variation 2 as boring and uninteresting existing text. The name will be new text. And then we'll go boring text. So again, we make it pretty clear which variation you're going to get. We could add additional variations if we wanted to do targeting rules. So if we wanted a third one that maybe our beta users are going to get, we could do that in another variation. But in this case, we're just going to stick with these two options. So we'll save our flag. Flag is created. It's off. We got bottom text there. We already defined that out in our code. So now instead of doing that ternary operator, what we're going to do is we're going to take this, delete it entirely, and we'll just throw this in brackets. So we have this bottom text displayed here. We'll go ahead and clear out this link for learning React. We're in the progress of learning React right now. And we'll go ahead and save this flag. Now, if we switch back to our application, we can see boring and uninteresting existing text is displayed on the bottom. And if we pop back into LaunchDarkly and turn this on, we can see it switches to deploy applications faster, which is still pretty boring in the grand scheme of things, but it serves the purpose of showing the idea of pushing an actual configuration change down to the application. So in this case, we've actually dynamically replaced the text based on a flag value. If I go in and I create another variation and set that as the primary validation or primary variation, that will be the one that is displayed here as well. This gives us, again, agility and the ability to deploy this faster. We can deploy this without repushing the code out. Once it's in production, it's always there for us to consume however we want. So for our final example, we're going to go ahead and bring in a new header on top. So far we've been just working with the existing React component, right? So we've just been working inside of App.js, but one of the most powerful things about React is how easy it is to build additional components and bring those into to LaunchDarkly. So what we're going to do is we're going to create a new folder. And just for simple sake, we're going to go ahead and call it header.js. And I have a simple snippet set up that'll build out kind of a basic component in React. So we'll name this one header. And what we'll do is welcome to LaunchDarkly and React. If you enjoy your stay. We'll throw a div around this so that we can get rid of that angry error message. And we'll format it and we are good to go. So now we have the basics of our application configured. What we'll want to do is we'll want to drop this component in again. Now in React, we want to import this component first. So we'll do import header. And then within our header class name, we'll go ahead and start to build out our LaunchDarkly component that'll handle evaluating if this should display or not. So similar before, we'll do a ternary operator. Actually, first we will go ahead and create definition of our flag here. So new header, we'll create that ternary operator. So we'll go new header, evaluate. If it's true, we want to load that header component. But if it's false, we'll just load a blank div. So now if I save this, I'm going to get an error message because ultimately new header is not created yet. So we want to go ahead and pop into LaunchDarkly real quick. We'll back out to feature flags, we'll create a new flag, name it new header. New header, make this a Boolean. Header text, blank, save our flag. Now, if I go back in and save our application, you see it's missing. We go into targeting, turn it on, save our changes. We can see our application is updated with that new header text. So again, we've pretty drastically changed this page from the ground up just by adding a few feature flags in that we're able to react to kind of variations that we've defined within the platform. It wouldn't be much of a stretch for us to continue developing this application and add new capabilities in from this point. We could bring in grid views that call it to a database and return those visually on the page, wrap those in feature flags, and gradually roll them out with those feature flags in the LaunchDarkly platform. We also could continue to tie in things like targeting rules so that we can apply specific configurations to different users who come in based on different properties. There's a wide range of things that we can do in the LaunchDarkly platform to continue to develop this out. We'll continue exploring those and tying this into future videos. But for now, I hope you enjoyed getting started very quickly with React and LaunchDarkly. Have a great day.